Hello and welcome to episode 6 of the PowerShell Jumpstart series. We'll take a look at try-catch. So welcome to error handling territory. Sometimes the unexpected happens and your script doesn't do what it's meant to. It also looks pretty ugly. There are terminating errors, where your script just stops where the error happens, it breaks. And there are non-terminating errors, where the script just keeps running and even though it failed at a particular step, it just keeps rolling and keeps doing its thing, even if it's not the thing you want to. So in order to tell PowerShell what to do in case it comes across an error, we can use try-catch. So for this purpose, I'll use a fake command. This is fake, this doesn't exist, so it will give me an error. I know that for sure. So it will tell me that it's not recognized. That's fine, that's what I wanted. So let's go ahead and wrap that in a try-catch block. So try to run this fake commandlet. And if it fails, do something. So it will catch the error. So catch and write a message. You can write, nope, didn't work. Let's see. Let's run this. And if comes across a terminating error, it will display nope, it didn't work, so our little block worked. Nice. All right, so let's try something a little bit different. Let's go ahead and try a getService commandlet. We know that exists. We'll actually make it search for a existing service, netlogon. So try to search for that, and if in case it doesn't work, it will display nope, it didn't work. So this displays the actual results from the commandlet. Okay, so now let's try with a fake service. And whoops, it didn't catch the error. What happened there? Okay, so what happened here is that it's not a terminating error. It's a non-terminating error, that means it just keeps going and displaying whatever happened there. So in order for try-catch to work, you need to make it terminating. That's really simple to do with the commandlets. All you need to do is add the error action and tell it what to do. So this parameter will help you make it a terminating error by using the stop option right there. So let's see how it goes this time. And it didn't work, you know, but I mean, our block worked, which is what we want. So let's go ahead and try to get the actual error that we're getting. That really comes in handy. So for that purpose, let's wrap it in quotes, and we will use the reserved variable for the try and catch error, which can be just the dollar sign and underscore, and you will get the actual error that happened there. You know, nice thing about this, you can do a lot of things with it. So you can do a write host, so you can do error, and it again, and you can play around with the results right there, so you get something more specific, you know, and you don't have to wonder what happened exactly. So let's go ahead and give this a try with test connection as well. So try, let's open our block here, try test connection, let's do google.com. We'll just do a count of one, so it doesn't take forever. And remember to add the error action parameter here. We'll tell it to stop, so it works with try catch. And catch something. So we will just do the error here. So error okay, let's give it a shot. And this should actually be getting the value from, you know, this connection because it works. But what happens if I use a fake server dot fake domain? So it's testing the connection and it should give us the error that occurred there. Okay, testing connection to computer fake server failed. No such host is known. So that's all I have for error handling, really. Important things to remember is that if you're using a commandlet, make sure you have the error action to stop for try and catch to work. All right, so that would be it for now. Thank you.